Over the next year, the U.S. Army will deploy more than 1,000 Switchblade 600 drones as part of Replicator, the Pentagon's initiative to field thousands of uncrewed systems. The quantity was disclosed by General James Mingus, the Army's Vice Chief of Staff, during a June 21st House Appropriations Defense Subcommittee hearing at the Defense Innovation Unit's headquarters in Mountain View, California. The Switchblade 600 is among the few systems the Defense Department plans to purchase in the first phase of the Replicator program. It is the only system named so far. Other planned acquisitions include an unspecified fleet of maritime drones through a DIU solicitation, collection of uncrewed surface vehicles, and countered drone systems. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the U.S. Army is acquiring 1,000 Switchblade 600 loitering munition. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Switchblade is a compact loitering munition designed by AEROVIRONMENT and utilized by various branches of the U.S. military. Small enough to fit in a backpack, the Switchblade is launched from a tube, flies to its target, and detonates its explosive warhead upon impact. Its name, Switchblade, comes from the way its spring-loaded wings are folded inside the launch tube and snap into place when deployed. First introduced in 2011, the original Switchblade was later named the Switchblade 300 after the larger and significantly different Switchblade 600 anti-armor variant was introduced in 2020. The Switchblade was developed to assist U.S. troops in responding to enemy ambushes in Afghanistan. Traditional close air support can be slow to arrive, costly to operate, and risks collateral damage in urban areas. Troop-carried guided missiles, like the FGM-148 Javelin, are much larger, heavier, and more expensive, with only a few typically carried on patrol. Human-portable UAVs, like the Raven or Puma, can identify threats but lack offensive capabilities. The backpackable, relatively inexpensive Switchblade combines sensors to locate enemy fighters and an explosive warhead to attack them from above, making it particularly effective against entrenched positions such as rooftops or ridgelines. Switchblade series has multiple variants, starting with Switchblade 300. Switchblade 600 is the big brother of the Switchblade 300, but fitted with an ATGM, anti-tank guided missile, warhead, based on the Javelin anti-tank missile, designed to neutralize tanks and heavy armored vehicles. This loitering munition represents the next generation of extended-range loitering missiles, delivering unprecedented RSTA, reconnaissance, surveillance, and target acquisition support, and featuring high-precision optics, over 40 minutes of loitering endurance, and an anti-armor warhead for engaging larger, hardened targets at greater distances. The Switchblade 600 weighs 54.5 kilograms, or about 120 pounds, including the all-up round in the tube and FCS. The airframe weighs 22.7 kilograms, or 50 pounds, with the fire control system consisting of a tablet and long-range antenna. The Switchblade 600 is equipped with high-resolution EO/IR gimbaled sensors and advanced precision flight control, which are used for navigation, surveillance, and targeting. The system is man-portable and can be set up in 10 minutes. It has a range of around 80 kilometers, or 50 miles, and is capable of attacking a target with 115 miles per hour or 185 kilometers per hour dash speed. A touchscreen tablet-based fire control system can manually or autonomously control the munition. It's secured through onboard encrypted data links and selective availability anti-spoofing module GPS with a patented wave-off capability. An optional pocket digital data link DDL module is also available. The Switchblade 600 was developed for the Army Single Multi-Mission Attack Missile development program. Other methods could include a six-pack vehicle-mounted version and by air launch. In October 2022, AEROVIRONMENT said it was capable of producing more than 2,000 Switchblade 600 systems annually, and that it planned, within a few months, to increase production capacity to 6,000 per year. The U.S. Army had already planned to buy the system through its low-altitude stalking and strike ordnance program, though in smaller quantities before it was selected for Replicator. Last October, the service announced that it would procure 100 Switchblades to test and field within Army units. The inclusion of Switchblade 600 into Replicator has long-term ramifications. Announced last August by Deputy Defense Secretary Kathleen Hicks, Replicator aims to achieve two main goals. In the short term, to deploy a large number of expendable drones to counter China, and in the long term, to establish a sustainable process for acquiring technology to address the department's most urgent operational needs. Hicks has stated last month that the department started fielding Replicator systems to Indo-Pacific Command in early May. In this context, it's to be noted that the United States is working on a strategy to stop any Chinese attempt to overtake Taiwan. The plan is straightforward. If mainland China invades Taiwan, it could face a lethal unmanned force intended to overwhelm its military and buy time. This strategy, known as the Hellscape Strategy, was articulated by the senior U.S. Admiral in the Pacific. Admiral Samuel Paparo, the commander of U.S. Indo-Pacific Command, told the Washington Post at the International Institute for Strategic Studies Shangri-La Dialogue Summit, "The idea is that as soon as China's invasion fleet begins moving across the 100-mile waterway, the U.S. military would deploy thousands of unmanned submarines, unmanned surface ships, and aerial drones to flood the area and give Taiwanese, U.S., and partner forces time to mount a full response." Switchblade 600, as part of Replicator, will likely be a key component of the Hellscape strategy.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.